In the last lecture, we saw the generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal by using the Hilbert transform, where we have determined the equation for upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal and lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal. Equation for the upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal was mt into cos 2 pi fct minus m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. And the equation for the lower sideband SSB-SC signal was mt into cos 2 pi fct plus m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. Now, if we examine the both equation, we can see that they differ from each other in only one respect, that is, the minus sign in the equation of the upper sideband is replaced by plus sign in the equation of the lower sideband. So, we can combine these two equations and define a sinusoidal SSB-SC modulated signal. So, sinusoidal SSB-SC modulated signal can be defined as mt into cos 2 pi fct plus minus m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. In this lecture, we will see how to generate SSB-SC modulated signal by using DSB-SC modulated signal. At first, we derive the expression for DSB-SC modulated signal by using a DSB-SC modulator. Although we have seen how to generate the DSB-SC modulated signal in the lectures of DSB-SC modulators, but in this lecture, we are going to see mathematical explanation of the generation of DSB-SC modulated signal. Let's consider a DSB-SC modulator where we have the modulating signal or message signal mt, which is equal to am cos 2 pi fmt, and the carrier signal ct is equal to ac cos 2 pi fct. This modulating signal and the carrier signal are given as the input to the modulator, and it will generate the DSB-SC modulated signal as the output. So mathematically, DSB-SC modulated signal can be given by ST is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT into AC cos 2 pi FCT, which can be written as ST is equal to AM into AC cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now, divide and multiply the equation of ST by 2, then it can be written as ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now, we know that 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A minus B plus cos A plus B. If we apply this formula in the following equation, then we can write ST is equal to AM into AC by 2 into cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. By multiplying AM into AC divided by 2 with both the terms, DSB-SC modulated signal ST can be written as ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. So the equation of the DSB-SC modulated signal can be given by ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. This equation of the DSB-SC modulated signal contains two terms. First term is AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T is known as upper sideband signal, and the second term AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T is known as lower sideband signal. The SSB-SC modulated signal contains either upper sideband or lower sideband, which can be generated from this DSB-SC modulated signal which contains both the sidebands. Now, suppose we would like to generate a SSB-SC modulated signal that retains upper sideband frequency at FC plus FM, then we can define this upper sideband signal as AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Now, we know that cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. If we apply this formula in the following equation, then it can be written as upper sideband signal is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT minus sin 2 pi FMT into sin 2 pi FCT. If we multiply AM into AC divided by 2 with both the terms, then it can be written as upper sideband signal is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT minus AM into AC divided by 2 sin 2 pi FMT into sin 2 pi FCT. Again, let's say we would like to generate a SSB-SC modulated signal that retains the lower sideband frequency at FC minus FM. So the lower sideband signal can be given by AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. Now we know that cos A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. If we apply this formula in the following equation, then it can be written as AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT plus sin 2 pi FCT into sin 2 pi FMT. If we multiply the term AM into AC by 2 with both the terms, then it can be written as lower sideband signal is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT plus AM into AC divided by 2 sin 2 pi FMT into sin 2 pi FCT. Now, if we combine the equation of upper sideband signal and the equation of lower sideband signal, then we can define sinusoidal SSB-SC modulated signal as AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT plus minus AM into AC divided by 2 sin 2 pi FMT into sin 2 pi FCT. We have already defined AM into cos 2 pi FMT is equal to MT or message signal. Now AM into sin 2 pi FMT is equal to AM into cos 2 pi FMT minus 90 degree. We know that Hilbert transform of a cosine signal is the 90 degree phase shifted version of the given cosine signal. So AM sin 2 pi FMT is the Hilbert transform of the message signal MT or AM cos 2 pi FMT. So we can write AM sin 2 pi FMT is equal to M cap of T. Now, if we put these values in the equation of sinusoidal SSB-SC modulated signal, then it can be written as AC by 2 into MT cos 2 pi FCT plus minus AC by 2 into M cap of T into sin 2 pi FCT. If we take AC by 2 common from the equation, then the sinusoidal SSB-SC modulated signal can be written as AC by 2 into MT cos 2 pi FCT plus minus M cap of T sin 2 pi FCT, which is similar to the SSB-SC modulated signal generated by using Hilbert transform with the amplitude of AC by 2. Now, by using this equation of the SSB-SC modulated signal, we will determine the related properties like bandwidth, power, efficiency, current and voltage of the SSB-SC modulated signal. Bandwidth of the SSB-SC modulated signal. So, the SSB-SC modulated signal transmits either upper sideband or lower sideband, and SSB-SC modulated signal which transmits the upper sideband can be defined as upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, which is equal to AM into AC by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into T, and the SSB-SC modulated signal which transmits on the lower sideband is defined as lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, which is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. Here, FC is the frequency of the carrier signal, FM is the frequency of the message signal, FC plus FM, which is equal to F maximum, is the frequency of the upper sideband, and FC minus FM, which is equal to F minimum, is the frequency of the lower sideband. Now, bandwidth of the DSB-SC modulated signal is equal to F maximum minus F minimum. DSB-SC modulated signal transmits both upper sideband and the lower sideband. So, F maximum is equal to FC plus FM and F minimum is equal to FC minus FM. So, bandwidth can be given by BW is equal to 2 into FM. Now, the SSB-SC modulated signal transmits either upper sideband or lower sideband. So, the bandwidth of the SSB-SC modulated signal or BW is equal to half into the bandwidth of DSB-SC modulated signal. So, bandwidth of the SSB-SC modulated signal is equal to half into 2 into FM. So, bandwidth of the SSB-SC modulated signal is equal to FM. Now, let us calculate the power of SSB-SC modulated signal. SSB-SC modulated signal is consist of either upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, which is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T, or lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, which is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. Both of them are cosine signals, and the power of the cosine signals can be given by Vrms square by R, where Vrms is equal to Vm by root 2. So power of the cosine signal is equal to Vm by root 2 whole square divided by R. Here, Vrms is the RMS value of the cosine signal and Vm is the amplitude of the cosine signal. Now, if the transmitted signal is upper sideband, then the power of the SSB-SC modulated signal is equal to power of the upper sideband, which is a cosine signal, and the power can be given by if we put the amplitude of the upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the place of Vm in the equation of power of the cosine signal. So the power of upper sideband signal is equal to Am into AC divided by 2, which is the amplitude of the upper sideband, divided by root 2 whole square divided by R, which can be simplified as Am square into AC square divided by 8R. Again, if we transmit the lower sideband signal, then the power of the SSB-SC modulated signal is the power of lower sideband. Lower sideband signal has the same amplitude as the upper sideband signal, which is equal to Am into AC divided by 2, and it is also a cosine signal. So if we put the amplitude of this cosine signal in the equation of the power of cosine signal, then for the lower sideband signal, power will be exactly equal to the power of the upper sideband, which is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. Efficiency of the SSB-SC modulated signal. Now, efficiency eta is equal to the ratio of usable power and the total power. Here, the usable power is the power of either upper sideband or lower sideband, and both of them is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. And the total power of the SSB-SC modulated signal is also the power of either upper sideband or lower sideband, and it is also equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. So if we take the ratio of usable power and total power for the efficiency of the SSB-SC modulated signal, then it will become 1 or 100%. So the efficiency of the SSB-SC modulated signal is equal to 100%. Now let us calculate the current in the SSB-SC modulated signal. We have seen that the power of the SSB-SC modulated signal P is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. Now we know that P is equal to I square into R, and if we put this value in the equation, then we can write I square into R is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. If we take R on the other side of the equation, then it can be written as I square is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R square. Now I can be calculated as Am into AC divided by 2 into root 2 into R. Voltage in the SSB-SC modulated signal. Again, the power of SSB-SC modulated signal P is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. If we put P is equal to V square by R in the equation, then it can be written as V square by R is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8R. If we cancel out R from both the sides of the equation, then it can be written as V square is equal to Am square into AC square divided by 8, and if we calculate the value of V, then it can be written as Am into AC divided by 2 into root 2. Let us see some advantage and the disadvantage of this SSB-SC modulation. SSB-SC modulation requires less bandwidth or spectrum space, and achieved efficiency is higher compared to amplitude modulated and DSB-SC modulated signals. It is possible to transmit more number of signals by using this SSB-SC modulation. It saves power compared to the other two modulation techniques. Higher power signal can also be transmitted by using SSB-SC modulation, and the transmission is less likely to be affected by the noise. Signal fading or loss of the signal is less likely to occur in this case of modulation. The disadvantage of this system is the generation of SSB-SC modulated signal and the detection of this signal is very complex, and it affects the signal quality when the transmitter and the receiver of SSB-SC have outstanding frequency strength. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.